That's wrap of the week in corporate stories. Robinsons lands 2023 net income hitting over 12 billion pesos. It says this was 24% higher year on year owing to the stronger performance of its malls, hotels, and joint ventures. Revenues, though, slid by 8% to 42 billion pesos. On sales, RLC says residential net reached a record 21 billion pesos, while joint venture project sales were at 19 billion. Meanwhile, ASEN and its subsidiary, Piavietar Energy, enters into a deal with Bright Knight Asia Pacific to develop renewable energy projects in the Philippines. Piavietar will become the designated RE platform of the undertaking and will be tasked to develop, construct, and operate the utility-scale projects. And finally, Capital Philippines approves the sale of a property by its subsidiary, Good Soil Marine Realty. The sale of the 25-hectare land in Batangas Province was closed with a non-related 30-party for 1.5 billion pesos. Keppel says the sale followed a strategic review of investments and an opportunity to sell the property at valuation. U.S. President Joe Biden draws a sharp contrast between him and his likely 2024 election rival, Donald Trump. In his fiery State of the Union address, the third one, Biden accused Trump of threatening U.S. democracy, bowing to Russian President Vladimir Putin, and failing to protect Americans during what he called the worst economic crisis in a century. He then made a case on why he should be given another term in office.
America cannot go back. I know how far we've come. 4 years ago, next week, before I came to office, the country was hit by the worst pandemic and the worst economic crisis in a century. Remember the fear, record losses, remember the spikes in crime and the murder rate? A president, my predecessor, failed the most basic presidential duty that he owes to American people, the duty to care. I came to office determined to get us through one of the toughest periods in the nation's history. We have. It doesn't make news, but in news in 1,000 cities and towns, the American people are writing the greatest comeback story never told.
And just in time for the celebration of International Women's Month, Biden also vowed to reinstate the Roe versus Wade, a landmark Supreme Court decision that provides abortion protection.
Those bragging about overturning Roe v. Wade have no clue about the power of women. But they found out when reproductive freedom was on the ballot, we won in 2022 and 2020, and we'll win again in 2024. If you, the American people, send me a Congress that supports the right to choose, I promise you, I'll restore Roe v. Wade as the law of the land again.
President Biden also announced the U.S. will construct a temporary port on the coast of Gaza that they can receive aid deliveries and get much-needed help to the residents of the besieged enclave. Senator J.V. Ejercito explaining his decision to withdraw support from an objection to the contempt order against troubled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. Ejercito said he initially backed Senator Robin Hood Padilla's objection to the contempt order issued by panel chairperson Senator Risa Hontiveros over Quiboloy's snubbing of their probe. But Ejercito changed his mind, saying there might be another way to convince the Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader to appear before the Senate.
That was the day that Secretary of Justice Boy Remulla announced that cases will already be filed against Pastor Quiboloy by the DOJ. For procedural practicality, he said that since DOJ will already file, then probably there's no more need for to continue the investigation. But okay. Senator Risa Ontiveros in the lounge said that Senator Nancy Binay suggested why not just online, no, for security purposes. She said that can be considered as long as Pastor Quiboloy acknowledges the committee.
Ejercito assures Quiboloy he will be treated fairly if he attends the inquiry into his alleged crimes. The pastor is accused of sexual abuse and human trafficking by former members of his group.